شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن.
So Ramadan Mubarak, everybody. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May you have a very blessed Ramadan. Ramadan is coming around the corner. Are you ready? Are you or you are not? If you are, there's a couple of things on my checklist here. First of all, when you go into Ramadan, go clean. Keep it clean. What does that mean? Go into your heart, first of all, make peace with your heart. All the things that are in your heart that are not supposed to be there, drop them. Wash them with that water of wudu, or take a spiritual ghusl before you go into Ramadan, where you wash all that clutter that's in the heart. So there's hate, grudges, ghibah, namima, backbiting, greed, envy, all that business. Take it out. The important thing is to go to Ramadan clean. If you go to Ramadan with a good heart, إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you may open for you that month, and you will actually reap the benefit from it. If you go in and your heart is filled with things, you haven't kept it clean, and then that's going to avail you from actually getting the reward. Number two, don't let fasting become only fasting of the GI tube, gastrointestinal tube, meaning nothing goes into your mouth, nothing goes into your stomach. That's not the way. So fasting is supposed to be more comprehensive. So fast so that your actions are only good. You fast from doing evil actions. That your words are only good. You fast from saying wrong words. And your thoughts generate only good thoughts. So you don't harbor or foster any negative thoughts. So you fast from evil thoughts. Fasting as a comprehensive thing. All right. Number three, forgive everybody. Regardless whether they're worthy of being forgiven or not. That's not important. You ought to be worthy of being of forgiving those who are not worthy. If you don't think so, forgive anyway. Why? Because you want Allah Ta'ala to forgive you even when you're not worthy of being forgiven. That's very important. Don't go to Ramadan and you're still holding grudges. Forgive. Number four, love everybody. Give them unconditional rahmah or love. Everybody. It doesn't matter who. Ask Allah to guide everybody and then to bless everybody. Guess what? You're not going to be more generous than Allah ever. Allah Ta'ala will give you that and more. And then during the month of Ramadan, go do good. I know Ramadan already allows you lots of things. So you do Taraweeh and prayer and Qiyamul Layl, and you do Quran, and you do, and there's also Zakah, and there's all kinds of things in Ramadan. But guess what? Try to do something also extra in Ramadan that's unique. I don't know what it is. You figure out something that's good that you do in Ramadan. With that, I wish all of you a very blessed Ramadan to you and your families and your loved ones, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring this Ramadan onto the world and make it peaceful and make have love flourish in the hearts of people again, and may He use us to work on that and bring that about. And also with that, inshallah, Allah grant you a great Eid as a prize after Ramadan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.